afternoon, student. How are you? I hope all you are fine. Stay home, stay safe. Okay. And it will study also in your home. Okay, now today I am going to teach you the next chapter. That is the second chapter in your syllabus. What is the thing? The geography grid distance. You, as you read in class 5, 6, this type of things, that what is the geographical grid. Now today again I repeat it once. Let's see. In a last chapter, we read about the earth. Earth side is a spherical in shape or sphere in shape. Now what is a spherical? Like this type shape is almost the sphere in shape. That is called the spherical shape. Now you see that in a earth, that the four pass in a two, one vertical line and one horizontal line that passed through. These vertical lines, as you know, later you read, that is known as the longitudinal line. And which one is the horizontal line? That is called this line. Which one is the east-west direction line? It's called the latitudinal line. Now, when a vertical and a horizontal line, they intersect with each other and they form the grid system. What is the grid system? That when a vertical line and a horizontal line, that both of them are intersect with each other, the intersect, the cross, this portion, it's known as the grid system. Now, what is grid? That we know about the grid system. What is grid? That like this type the many lines, like the many horizontal lines and the vertical lines are there in the world. Now, what happened? This all the horizontal line, you see, this all the horizontal line is goes through from the east-west direction. Now, what it did? That it divide the earth into two equal parts. What is the two equal part? That the first one, the upper one, is known as the north pole. North, and down one is the south. Or either you can call also northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. And which one is the vertical line that goes through from the north-south direction? It divides the earth into two equal parts. But is the one side is called the western hemisphere and the another side is called the eastern hemisphere. So, like this type, the main the latitudinal lines are being present, and the same way, longitudinal lines are also be there. What's the longitudinal line? Like this type, the longitudinal lines are also be present in this portion. Now, this when the latitudinal line and longitudinal line are being intersect with each other, they form a square shaped box. This type, the square shaped box they have to form. This square shaped box are known as grid. And when the two all squares box two or more grid together, they are known as grid system. Now the next is that all the grids and the grid system, they have to, why you should use it? This all the latitudinal line and the longitudinal line, why we should use in a map? Because you know what is the reason for that? Because that by through this latitudinal and longitudinal line, we can easily locate the any place in all over the world in a map or globe. By through it easily, we can locate any place in throughout the world by the using of this two line. That is why we use this latitudinal and longitudinal line and the grid also, because it helps us to locate the any place in the all over the world. And in a globe, we can easily, in a proper, you have to understand this about the grid. Now here, we have to read about the two things. The first one is the latitudes and second is the longitude. So first we discuss about the latitudinal line. So what is the definition of the latitudinal line? That what is latitudinal line? That which line, which horizontal imaginary line that goes through from the center of the earth surface, from the different part in a horizontal way, from the east to west direction. This type the horizontal imaginary line are known as latitudinal line. What is the latitudinal line? Again I repeat it. That which horizontal imaginary line that pass through from the east to west direction in a map or globe. This horizontal imaginary line are known as latitudinal line. Now in our world, we have the five major latitudes. You know what their names? The first one is the equator. Which one is goes through to the center of the earth surface is known as equator. Now this line is very important for us. Why it is very important for us? Because it goes through the center of the earth surface and it divides equally. the both the part that the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere into the two earth parts. That is why the two hemisphere. That is why the equator is very important. And not only for this reason, the another reason is that this is value of this line is the 0 degree. And all the other natural line, like the Tropic of Cancer on the Arctic Circle, Tropic of Capricorn, Antarctic Circle, they are all the values like the 23.5 degree north, 66.5 degree north, either here also 23.5 degree north, the south, and 66.5 degree south. These all the lines, their values are also being calculated from the equator. That is why the equator is the very important latitudinal line among all the other latitudes. So if the question will come, why the equator, what is the definition of equator, what to write? That which horizontal imaginary line are passed through in the center of the earth surface and that divide the earth into two equal hemispheres, that is the northern and southern hemisphere. This horizontal imaginary line are known as equator. Now what is the importance of this line? What to write? That this line is divide the earth, it goes through the center portion, so it divides the earth into the two equal parts. And the another point is that this line values the 0 degree, so other latitudinal line value has been calculated due to form this equator. That is why the equator is very important imaginary line or the latitudinal line. So I hope that you have to understand up to here. Next day I discuss more about this chapter and about the different type of latitudinal and longitudinal line in the next class. So I hope you have to understand. And those are the question answers I gave in the last day, that from the previous chapter you should have to complete in your copy. Just write properly. Okay. And thank you.